Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this Photoshop Creative Cloud tutorial, I will show you how to apply a colorful poster effect to an image. I have utilized smart objects and adjustment levels to make the result non-destructive and easily tweakable. This technique works well with images containing people of a size where they are not too close but far enough away to make out general features. Also, city, street, and market scenes seems to work well. I'll also show you how to make a Photoshop action so that you can run the action on other images easily. Open your image in Photoshop. Press Alt F9 or choose Actions from the Windows menu. If you do not already have a personal action set, select New Set. Name it My Actions or whatever you prefer. Select New Action. Name it Poster Effect and make sure My Actions or your existing personal action set is chosen in the set box. Press Record to start saving your actions. Press the double arrow at the top of the panel to collapse it. Right-click on the layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. We will be using the Smart Object and Adjustment layers, so settings can be changed easily after we're done. Next, apply a Gaussian blur filter. We'll set the blur to 10 for now. We can modify it later if necessary. The purpose of the blur is to even out and soften the colors and details. Once the blur is applied, right-click on the Gaussian blur words in the layer panel and choose Edit Smart Filter Blending Options. Change the blend mode to darken. Alternatively, you can double-click the double triangles with lines above them to the right of the Gaussian blur filter in the layer panel. Apply the poster edges filter. With edge thickness 1, edge intensity 0, and posterization 6. In Photoshop Creative Cloud and above, poster edges is found in the filter menu under Filter Gallery. In earlier versions, you can find it in the filter menu under Artistic. Add a levels adjustment layer by clicking the New Adjustment Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. Select the Auto button for now. Add a Hue and Saturation Adjustment Layer. Click X in the upper right-hand corner to close and leave the default settings for now. Create a new layer by clicking Layer, New, Fill Layer, Solid Color. When the New Layer dialog box appears, make the name Saturation, the Mode Saturation, and the Opacity 10%. Click OK to accept. When the color picker appears, choose a light blue color, such as 70D0F0. Click OK to accept. Expand your Actions panel, then select the black square button at the bottom to stop recording. Select the My Actions set. Select Save Actions from the Settings drop-down. You'll get a Save As screen. Before clicking Save, change the file location to a folder on your local drive. Here I changed it to Documents, My Presets, a folder I have created to hold personal actions, brushes, etc. Then click the Save button to save the My Actions set to your local drive. You can choose whatever location you want. If you ever lose your actions, you can point to them in the local drive folder and load them back in. At this point, we could start making adjustments to improve the image. The image looks a little too blurry, so double-click the Gaussian blur layer and move the setting to 5. This will vary depending on the size, resolution, and content of your picture. Open up your levels adjustment layer and lighten up the grays and whites a bit. I use the setting shown here, but this will vary depending on the image you are working with. Adjust the hue and saturation layer. I moved the saturation slider over till the light from the building by the two benches on the right started to show a glow. In general, adding some saturation will brighten up the colors and give the image a more comic effect. However, don't overdo it. Adjust the blue saturation layer. Adjust the opacity on this layer to give a colorful glow to the street and colored objects. I used an opacity of 20% here. Play with the opacity slider till you find what you like. Finally, I tweaked hue and saturation levels a bit more. I then added a new layer on top of the layer stack and used Edit Fill to fill it with 50% gray and make the blend mode overlay. I named the layer Pseudo Dodge Burn. I then used a white soft round brush at opacity 18% to lighten up a few of the people's faces. I also switched the brush color to black and darkened up some of the background buildings. This is a non-destructive way of dodging and burning light and shadow into subjects. If you make a mistake, just paint over it with 50% gray. At this point, we are done. Save your image now. Save it as poster final. Optionally, we can now add halftone dots and a border to give it a comic look. Save your image again as poster comic. Crop out a smaller section of the image. Here is the section I used from the original image. Fit the image to the screen. Choose Ctrl plus Alt plus Shift plus E to make a composite layer. Name it Composite. Right-click and choose Smart Object. To make a border, click the FX icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. Then choose Stroke. Make the size 30 pixels. And the position inside. And leave the color as black. To add color halftone dots, make sure the composite layer is still active. From the filter menu, choose Pixelate Color Halftone. Choose a radius of 6. Leave the rest of the settings at default. Right-click on the word Color Halftone in the Layer menu and select Edit Smart Filter Blending Options. When the Blending Options dialog box appears, choose Soft Light for the mode and 50% for the opacity. Note, depending on the size and resolution of your image, The radius size, blending mode, and opacity may differ. Here is the image after applying halftone dots and the black border. Since you have recorded the poster action, you can quickly have fun trying it out on other images. I have tested a bunch of pictures out with this action and have placed some of them on my website. The link is in the description area. To run the action on another picture, load the image into Photoshop. Access the Actions panel by choosing Alt F9 or choose Actions from the Windows menu. Select the poster effect and press the Run control at the bottom of the Actions panel. Make adjustments as necessary, as we did before in this tutorial. I've sped up the video here to save time. This concludes the tutorial. I hope you can make some interesting images by following these methods. Thanks for watching.